Thank you, Shen. Thank you very much, dear friends. Thank you very much for the invitation to come here. There are many, many reasons to be happy and honored to be here. One of them, of course, is your invitation, especially Diederik's invitation. And the second one is that Europe is not only Brussels. Europe are all the capitals and all the cities and all the regions. And the European parties are all our member parties. And the Partei van de Arbeid is an important member party. And I'm very, very happy, I must say to you, Diederik, personally, but also to many other colleagues, that the Partei van de Arbeid plays a big role, a bigger role perhaps than in some of the past years, and that is very important. We saw it also at the last summit. Don't let Europe to the people in Brussels. Europe is an issue for us all, and I know it because I come from a country far away from Brussels than you are, and that is very important that we have a new impetus. And we have a new chance after the elections in France, after the elections in some countries like Slovakia and other countries. The social democracy in Europe is on the rise again, and we should take the chance, and you should take the chance. But first, let me tell another reason why I'm so happy to be here. When I was a young student, that was the first time in the Netherlands. And the students' organizations here in the Netherlands showed me around the country. What was important for me? The Netherlands. The Netherlands were in the core of Europe. They were founders of Europe, and they were convinced about Europe and the necessity of Europe. Secondly, nevertheless, the Netherlands always looked to the outside world. It was not a Europe conception of enclosure. No, it was a Europe conception of playing a strong role in the world, in the global world. Third, Netherlands always was a model country for social partnership, for working together between labor and industry, but of course with a special importance for the labor side and the trade unions. And fourth, the Netherlands always was a country of entrepreneurial spirit. Innovation, research, development, entrepreneurship always has been in the heart of the development of the country. And these four elements are what we need in Europe. We need a closer Europe to be a strong Europe. We need a Europe which is looking to the outside world, is active in the world, is trying to determine what's about globalization, not leaving to the others. If they are Chinese or Russians or whatever, we have to be part of those who determine what the global world should look like. Europe is about social cohesion. Can we accept that the difference between the poor and the rich was rising, that the gap is rising in Europe? Can we accept that social partnership does not really play a role in Europe? We cannot, because we see also that those countries who are successful, also industrially and economically successful, like Germany, like the Netherlands, like Austria and other countries, are countries who are social-oriented countries, are countries who rely on a social partnership and know that the trade unions also play a big role. And fourth, what we need more in Europe is entrepreneurial spirit. We need innovation. We can only compete with China and other countries if we are countries who do a lot of spending in research and development. If we are a European Union who is open to new innovation, who is open for development, and who knows that also entrepreneurial activities and spirit is necessary to go forward. And therefore, I think that we need the Netherlands, but we need the Netherlands with a strong social democracy. Yes, colleagues and friends, we are, after this summit, in a period of change. We said adieu, we said goodbye to Mercosur. Let's say welcome social democracy in Europe, because we started it already. There are some prime ministers, you know one much better than I do, who say nothing changed, everything is okay. Even Madame Merkel has to confess there is a change. And of course there is a change. With François Hollande and other social democrats playing a bigger role, there is a change. Even with Mario Monti, who is not a socialist, but he's a man of reason, a man who knows the reality, there is a change. So also from this conference, I don't interfere into internal politics, but also from this conference I want to say, he visited me recently, so I can say it, Mr. Rutte, there was a change. Recognize the change. If you don't want it, I can accept that, but there is a change in Europe, and you will have to accept that. What is the change? Look, until now, austerity was the only word some people heard. If it was Mama Merkel or others, only austerity. And the so-called Merkozy cause, of course, was not Merkozy, it was Merkel and Sarkozy said, si, si, madame. Yes, that's it, that was Merkozy. But the things have changed. They have changed not because there's a radical left which now is taking over. There's a reasonable left, a left which says, let's see the reality. How can we come out of the crisis if we have only austerity? Yes, we have to save. Yes, we have to have budget and fiscal responsibility. And I know that this party is a party of fiscal responsibility, but responsibility is fiscal, but also for the jobs, for the people who work, for the people who are unemployed, and there are many in Europe. Fortunately, not so many in your country and in my country, but there are too many unemployed, especially the unemployment of the youth is unacceptable. How can we convince the youth to be for Europe? How can we convince young people to be for Europe if we say, we don't have a job for you, but go with us for Europe? Or because we now think about the development of Europe for the future. I'm very much for it. We have to think about adapting Europe. But should we go to the people and say to the unemployed in Spain, in Italy, in Greece, and all the other countries, sorry, you start your professional life being jobless, being unemployed, but let's join the discussion about the future of Europe. Let's think about changing the treaty. This is the big issue, not your job. This is not possible. And therefore, social democracy must say, yes, let's think about Europe. How can we adapt? How can we renew? But let's think about what can we do now to create jobs? How we can come close now? And one element where we have been always strong, and I'm very happy that you have it in your program, is of course the regulation of the financial market. Isn't it a scandal again, I don't know if you read it, that in Britain and the Barclays Bank, they manipulated again the market in order to get high profits and high bonuses? Somebody said in a mockery from Barclays Bank, some years ago, okay, we know we are always automatically responsible for scandals. Now they are really responsible. And the same government and the same conservative ideology says, no control to the banks, no control to the financial markets. The financial markets are the most important things. And both social democrats say, yes, we need financial markets. We need them for the pension funds, for other issues. But please, responsible financial markets. We don't want that the pensions of our people got lost because you speculate. You have the bonuses and the people lose the pension. This is not the financial market we can accept. And therefore, we also, social democrats, agree with the so-called banking union. The expression is not very well, because people anyway think we are a banking union and not a union of the citizens. So perhaps we should rather say a supervision of banking union, or find some other expression to make it clear it's about supervision of the banks. But do you know, colleagues, that 2 years ago, my political group, our political group, European Parliament, proposed that. And then all the governments, including the government in this country, said, no, that's much too far, European supervision of the banks, we don't need that, we can do that our own. Yes, we saw how they can do it. We see how they do it in Britain. We see how they do it in other countries. So let's go for that way. Yes, we need more Europe on the question of the supervision of banking. We need more Europe on the restriction on the boni. We need more Europe on the control of the financial market. And we need also, and I'm very happy, and I know your reservation concerning the pension fund, that you deal also with financial transaction tax. Let's be reasonable. Of course we want more in many countries. In other countries they want less. Let's start with it. Let's start in an enhanced cooperation with the financial transaction tax. Let's have the exceptions, which for example you need, but let's start that also the financial market makes a contribution to the costs of the crisis. It cannot be accepted that the costs of the crisis are borne by those who are the victims, who are unemployed, who have lower incomes. Also the financial market has to contribute. Let me also frank, yes, as I said, we need savings, we need cutting also on the budget, but in a reasonable time frame. What does it make sense that a troika or non-troika of the Commission is coming and said you have to do that and that and that, knowing already that it doesn't work? One of the examples, of course, is Greece, and they made many mistakes. And I was 3 times in Greece only this last month to look how the things are. Yes, they have to do a lot of a job, but the real job, the reform of the government, the cutting of the overblown administration, to have to build up a tax administration. The first thing the Commission should have demanded, do a real tax administration. The second thing the Commission should have demanded, what about the capital going to Switzerland and to other countries? Do you have an agreement with them? I asked, it was more than a year ago, the president of Switzerland, are you ready to conclude an agreement with Greece on these issues? They said yes. Until now it's not done. These are the issues that have to be done. And therefore I'm very happy, again, that in your program, as in our program, it is very clear. We fight against this tax evasion. We fight against this tax schemes and tax havens. Can you imagine that 1,000 billion, I don't know, there are some financial experts that have perhaps an imagination what it is. I don't know what it is, but it's quite a lot of money, I would say. 1,000 billion of euro are lost in Europe because of tax evasion, the unfair tax exemption, and the fleeing into the tax havens. This must have a stop and an end. We want the taxes here. And therefore, dear colleagues, yes, I'm very often asked, yes, you want investment, you want more investment. Again, in your program stands about priority for investment in the public sector, growth-oriented investment. Where's the money? We don't have the money. We would like to invest. There is no money. There is no money in the bank accounts of Switzerland. There is no money in the Bahamas. There is no money in London or in Frankfurt. There is no money when you see the speculation around. There is no money when you see how high the interest rates are for Spain and for Italy, for example. What about the earnings of somebody must earn the money? And I tell you, it's not the poor people who all of a sudden get rich. It's the rich who get richer. And therefore, the fight against tax evasion is very important, also to get the money to invest. I'm also an economist, I know of the importance of the financial sector. But let me say one thing, it's not the productive sector who should contribute to the financial sector. But the financial sector is here to contribute to production and jobs. This is the task of the financial sector. This is what we have to do, to have it really as a, if you want to say, as a servant of the productive sector where we create new jobs. And there's a lot of jobs possibility in Europe. People sometimes say, well, it's the end of industrialization in Europe, the jobs got lost. And I tell you one thing, you know it from your country, I know it from my country, Austria, and I know it from the country like Germany. You can have quality jobs in Europe in competition with Chinese and others, but of course we have to take up the competition. In the papers today is written the way of China from a low income and low wage country to a country which is going towards high quality jobs and high quality competition. Because the wages are rising also there, because people demand a better environment, because people demand a better social situation. It's not the, you know, the country who just delivers bananas and coffee. It's different now. But we have to take up the competition. But for me and for us as social democrats, it's not the competition of low wages. It's the competition of quality, the competition of innovation, the competition of giving the people a chance to produce and to show what they can and their capacities. And I tell you, and you know it from your country, we have enough capacities in our countries. Let's have some growth, some demand that we can sell also the things we produce, not only in China and in other countries, but also in Europe, because there are enough demands to do it. In an ecology, in a sustainable development, because this is another issue which is very important. Again, because I see many colleagues also from the European Parliament here, we fight for the quality of life and for sustainability and for the energy saving. I know that your country is very strong also in the energy business, growing oil and gas, and we will for many years have necessary. But whatever we can do to reduce our dependence is very important. So I'm happy that with the Danish presidency we could agree on an energy savings or energy efficiency directive, because still we have a lot to do for energy efficiency. We have to change our industrial and our structure and our lives towards more energy efficiency, less dependence on energy. There are so many things to do and to invest. Could you imagine how many jobs could be created if we really go for energy efficiency, if we really go for reconstructing our houses or for improving energy-wise our housing stock? There are a lot of jobs, again, because people say, yeah, we don't have jobs. We don't have jobs because we don't spend. We don't have jobs because we invest. We have a lot of jobs. Let's invest to create the jobs. So, just one word on to the social dimension again. We social democrats know, as I said, we need entrepreneurial spirit, we need activities, we need investment. And that, of course, we need also a tax system which is inducing investment. But the purpose, of course, is also to save our principal social model. Do we have to adapt our pension system? Do we have to adapt our social system? Yes, we have to adapt. If people live much longer than before, we cannot have the same system, we have to change it. But I warn you, I agree, but I warn you, some people misuse the reform for abolishing it. And we social democrats, we are the reformers, but we are not those who abolish the social system and the social partnership. That's the difference. Because again, if the neoliberals, also some in the Commission say, the most important thing is to go down with the wages, to go down with the salaries, to go down with the pensions, and to abolish more or less the labor law and the cooperation between the trade unions and the employers. Is that what is done in Germany? And therefore Germany is so unsuccessful. Is that what is done in the Netherlands? Or at least, is that what is done in Austria? And we have the lowest unemployment rate because we cut the wages. We have the lowest unemployment rate because we cut the rights of the trade unions. In the contrary, if you have a good climate, a good understanding, if you have responsible people on both sides, on the industry and on the labor side, you can have the most successful countries. And therefore, we say to the Commission again, reform, yes. Rigidities have to be done away. But we stick to the social model of Europe because it's our identity, the social model of Europe. So let me come to the end. It's about Europe. And I'm very happy that you personally, but many of your colleagues and many I saw also on the list for the Parliament, they are quite active in Europe. And Europe, again, is not only Brussels, it is not only the European Parliament, but all the national parliaments together. We have to build the citizens' Europe, not the Europe of some elites. This is what our task is, and therefore new cooperation and new line of connection between the national parties, the national parliament and European parliament, European parties, absolutely important. I'm very happy I find so many friends here in the social democracy on this line. And the second, last remark. I know you have the left, unfortunately, is not only social democracy, but there are many differences. The one, the European conviction of this party is true, not just before the election. It's a long tradition of European conviction, social democracy, in the Partij van de Arbeid in the Netherlands. And therefore, the Partij van de Arbeid plays a big role in the European social democracy. And secondly, you have friends. You have many friends. You're not alone. We need you in Europe as part of a European social democratic development and movement. We need you in Europe to continue the upsurge of social democracy in Europe. Others may have phrases, slogans, which sound much better. You have the conviction, you have the reason, and you have the determination to change Europe, and you have the capability to change Europe, together with other social democrats, because you're friends, you have comrades, and we are in solidarity with you, and you are in solidarity with us. And this is what our social democracy is about, solidarity in Europe, for the poor, but also for the Europe, for the social democracy. Thank you.